So now that we've talked about the EX3 driver program and kind of shown some of the main parts of the program and how the app works, let's kind of dive into some of the various helper classes we've got. We'll start with back pressure subscriber. And it's a Flux subscriber that implements back pressure. And you can see here that it implements the subscriber interface parameterized with this thing called prime utils result, which is just indicates whether something was a prime number or not. And if it was, it has a value 0. If it was not, it has its smallest factor. And it also implements disposable. So we can get rid of this thing using the disposables class. I have a little kind of a debugging tool in here just called the number of pending items. I use that for flow control stuff. We'll take a look at that in a second. We also define some other helper classes. We have a subscription, which is used to help control back pressure. You may be familiar with that if you go back and watch the early videos on reactive programming. There's basically this concept of a publisher and a subscriber and a processor and a subscription. So subscription is that entity that basically could be used by a subscriber to tell the publisher how many elements to send it before it's considered full, or its window is considered full, if you will. And then we keep track of whether we've been disposed or not. We have a countdown latch that's used by the driver program to basically wait until all the computations are done running asynchronously before it will return. It's a clever technique you'll see here in a second. This is basically the same technique that's used by the block or block optional operators in Project Reactor or blocking get in RxJava. And then we also have the default request size, which of course can be overridden by command line parameters. Here's the constructor. We give it the pending item count and stash it away. We're not disposed yet. And the number of items processed since the last request starts out at 0. Now, the key thing with a subscriber, whatever kind of subscriber you implement, you typically want to define the onSubscribe, if you're doing flow control, the onNext, onComplete, and onError hook methods. So in this particular case, we're going to have onSubscribe. Remember, onSubscribe is the method that the publisher first calls back on the subscriber, passing in a subscription object. And that's our hook to do a bit of initialization. So what we do here is we initialize the countdown latch with a value of 1 so that the caller that calls await won't continue till an onComplete or onError operator has been emitted, a signal has been emitted. We store the subscription for later use, and we set the initial request size. So this is basically telling the underlying publisher, you can send me this number of items before I'm considered full. And we'll see what the next request size does. So if we have back pressure turned on, then we're going to say, I want this many items to start with. If we have back pressure turned off, because we're not caring about back pressure, we just give it the max value of integer. And that says, that's an indicator to the publisher, send as many items as you possibly can, as fast as you can send them. I'm somehow miraculously either going to buffer all that stuff or I'm going to keep up. So you can pick your poison, if you will, whether you want to enable a subscription that will have a kind of a fixed size like 10 or 2 or 1 or whatnot, or whether you want to blast it out as fast as it'll go. Here's the onNext method. The onNext method, of course, is called by the publisher when it wants to emit the next item. And in this particular case, it's going to print the results of the prime number checking. So I don't have this turned on right now because it's very verbose, but if we're a prime number, then we indicate it's a prime number. If not, we say what the smallest factor is. And then I've also got some perhaps overly clever things here to try to do adaptive back pressure, which tries to say, send me the next item only ever so often. And I'm not yet fully convinced that this does what I think it does, but I left it in here just because I'm going to keep playing around with it for fun. The onError hook method gets called back if something goes wrong, if the upstream publisher has an error. And you can see what it does is it prints out what the problem was, and then it releases the latch because we don't want to wait anymore after an error has occurred. And likewise, the onComplete method prints complete or completed, and then it also releases the latch since we're done. So that will let the caller that's here in the await call go ahead and return. So this call is called by the calling thread, the one that runs after subscribe is called. So all the subscription stuff, when subscribe starts, it's going to run asynchronously in those background threads we saw, either one thread for both the publisher and subscriber, or one thread for the publisher and one or more threads for the subscriber. But the calling thread will then block on await until the latch is released when countdown counts down to zero. And then we've also just got a few flags to set whether things are disposed or not. So that's basically the subscriber that we're implementing. This is the back pressure subscriber, and it's really conditionally the back pressure subscriber because it only does back pressure if we set that flag on the command line.